Hey guys, welcome in Mastering Angular 15 from Beginners to Advanced course. In today's lecture, we will see how to make HTTP GET, POST, PUT and DELETE requests with the HTTP client. And for these all, let's see our application structure. First is component for displaying list. This component will showcase a list of items and links for add item. Each item in the list will have edit along with a delete button. And second is component for add edit functionality. This component will be responsible for adding new items to the list and editing existing items. So it means that we need two components. One is for listing and delete button and second is for add and editing. So let's create these two components in our application. And our first component will be list component, and for that I'm going to write this command ng-generate component list. And now I'm going to create add edit component. For that we need to write this command ng-generate component add edit. And now we have these two components, addEdit and list. Now for these two components we need routing so that we can access them by these routes. First I'm going to define default path, and this is for the list component. And then let's define the path for addEdit. And its component will be addEdit component. Next, I need to define the path for edit, and in edit we need id as a parameter. By this colon we define that this id parameter is dynamic. And for edit we also have the component addEdit component. For add we are not adding any parameter, but in edit we are passing the parameter id by which we will edit our component. Now let's implement our list component. First of all, here we need to import our HTTP client, private HTTP and HTTP client. As here we will import the list of posts. So first I need a variable post and its type is array. As we initialize our data in ng-onInit, so we will make get request by using HTTP client in this, and this is an open source library which we are using as a backend. As this is an async operation, in this we don't have directly available all the values, so we will subscribe it. And after subscribing its value, now we will store it in our post variable. Let's make it more meaningful, so I'm going to replace this x with posts. Now let's write the HTML for these posts. And I'm going to replace this default HTML with my own div. And now in this first I'm going to define the class of container. Then I'm going to write this h1 tag list of posts. After this h1 tag I also want to display a button, and for that I'm going to use this router link. And in this router link I have defined the path of add button, and its name will be add new post. And for styling I'm going to add this class add link. Now as we want to display our list, so for that I'm going to use this ul tag. And in this ul tag I will use this class for the styling post list. Then I will use the tag li and I will apply an ng for loop by which we will access all our posts and display it on the front end. Let post of posts, and then in h3 tag we will display the titles of these posts. And in p tag we will display its body. And next we will display the links of delete and edit buttons. First I'm going to write the router link for edit exactly like we have written for add link. and then after the edit I'm going to write the button for the delete. As you can see, we have defined the router links for both add and edit, but we are writing button for delete post. That is the reason we have defined the routers for add and edit, but we haven't defined any route for delete. And we are going to delete this post by clicking this delete post function. As we are getting an error on this function, so first let's implement it in our TS file. Delete post, and in this I will pass ID of type any, and now we will call the HTTP function delete here, and in this we need to pass the same URL, but we will append it with the ID. Now we will subscribe it, and then we can write an alert: post deleted. So until now we have implemented the functionality of get list of posts and delete posts. Next we need to implement the functionality of add edit, and we will implement this add edit functionality in our add edit component. But first let's run the application and see these functionalities on the front end. As you can see, this entire list of posts, and here we have our two router links add and edit and one delete button. As you can see, list functionality is working. Now let's test this delete button. I'm going to click on it and let's refresh the page. So it's deleted one post. Next let's implement add edit functionality. For add edit functionality, first I need to create a form group by which we can add edit our form. Form of type form group. Then in constructor I'm going to initialize my HTTP client service. Next I'm going to import the router service for the sake of redirection. Next we also need to import activated route, as this will return activated route so we can get the ID, cause in case of add we don't need any, but in case of edit we need ID so that we can edit our object. Next we need to create our form, and for that we need to import our form builder. Now by using this form builder I'm going to initialize my form. This.form is equal fb.group. And now in this group, I'm going to initialize the fields title and body. And initially, these both the fields will be empty. Now our form is generated. Next, we will see either we have our add page or edit. And for that, we will use our activated route. And if we get ID, it means that this will be our edit page. But if ID is null, then we need to redirect towards add page. For that we need to write const id is equal this.route.snapshot.parametric.getid. After getting the value of the id, now I'm going to use it in conditional statement. If id not equal to empty and id not equal to null, then we will call here our get function. And for that we will use the exact post link but with the get function. Then I'm going to subscribe it, and after getting the response I will write this.form.pageValue. Now what this pageValue function do? It will update our data in bulk. So we will set all the values in this pageValue from the front end. Title is equal to response.title, then body is equal to response.body. Next I need to write the savePost function. And in this we will update all the values on the backend that we all set up on the front end by using patch value. Now in the save post function, if this.id not equal to empty or null, then by using the put function of HTTP client service, I will update my particular post. Now in put and post function, we also need to add second parameter, and that will be this.form.value. Then again we need to subscribe it, and on success where I want to navigate it on the list page. Now if id is equal to null or empty, then it will be post call. So in that case we will replace this put with the post function, and in post we don't need any id. So now our functionality of HTTP client services is completed. We have implemented the listing, deletion, updation and addition. Now we will implement the functionality of both these functions, addition and updation, in HTML. First I'm going to write the div. In this main div I'm going to write the class container. Next, I need to write this h1 tag, add, update, post. Next, I'm going to write the HTML for my form in fast mode. If you want to see it in detail, then you can see my forms related videos. Here on ng-submit we will call our function savePost. Then we will decide if we get id from the parameter, it will invoke our put function, otherwise our add function. Now let's run the application and test these functionalities on the front end. First let's see the edit functionality, and for that I'm going to click on this edit button. Now let's click on the save button. So it again redirects us to listing page. Now I'm going to click on the add new post button so that we can add new post here. And after adding these values, again I'm going to click on the save button. And after adding these values in our post list, it again redirects us to the listing page. And next let's click our delete button. And I'm going to click on it. And this was our listing page. As you can see, we have implemented all the functionalities of our HTTP client service. Hope you understand it. If you still have any question or query, you can ask in comments. But if this lecture is helpful for you guys, then please like, subscribe, and share my channel. Thanks for watching.